When the Argus moved to its new home on Manchester Street, their enormous archive of photographs and glass plate negatives could not go with them. In stepped Andy Garth, who, along with his team at Brighton and Hove Stuff, has archived the collection.
I've got the guardianship of the local newspaper, the Evening Argus, or the Argus as it's now called, their photographic archive, which amounts to probably 40, 50,000 photographs. And today is an example of some good original photographs which were exhibited and selling. The photographs out today span from 1960 to 1992. We've also got a screen up which is showing the glass plate negatives from 1929 to the early 60s. So a wide range of years. Photographs date back to 1929 because that was the first time they put pictures in newspapers in Brighton. But the Argus is 137 years old, so it's been here for a long time. But the photographs physically only started going in newspaper in 1929. I had to theme them, but we've got about 1,000 photographs here. So we've got quite a few royalties with different Queen, etc., Queen Mother, Prince Philip. We've got sport, we've got the rock bands that are playing in Brighton. We've got obviously politics because we have the conferences down here, so we've got a range of all parties that came down here for the conferences. You know, demonstrations, anything and everything that happened in Sussex is recorded here. I quite like the fact that we've got some Daleks on the seafront, with the Doctor Who thing being quite a big thing at the moment, and some of the pop bands that were here in the sort of 70s and 80s that are still coming back. We found a Bananarama photo, and you know, now they're coming back at last. So everybody and people that you wouldn't expect, like, you know, we've got a Nobel Peace Prize winner who was at Sussex University. We've got Reverend Audrey, who wrote Thomas the Tank Engine, who was here. And even down to Charlie Chaplin standing on the balcony of a Brighton hotel with his wife in the mid-70s. Just fantastic choice of different things. These photographs are available online on our website, brightonhostaff.co.uk. But we can go through the Argus and look them, but we've got nearly 30,000 images that people can look at, download, and enjoy, because there's something there for everybody.
Yes, it is, yes, and there are several of my pictures they've found, which is rather nice, and especially this one with the with all these hundreds of people here. I had the job of counting them. It was a competition run by national coaches or whatever, and they wanted to know how many people exactly were in that picture, so I had to do a huge blow-up, grid it, and then count the whole lot.
Again, far too many to remember, but particularly the Royal Pavilion fire was just a traumatic late night phone call. You don't know what you're going to turn up to when you do. It's seen a complete devastation.
That's right, there's quite a few photographs here from other contests I was in as well. Some I'd forgotten all about, and I didn't even remember when I'd won them, but some amazing pictures, not just of me, but everybody here, and it's lovely to see all the old pictures of people from the past, I call it, yes.
Yeah, on the night I knew the manager of the Grand Hotel at the time, and he let me up on the roof. He probably wasn't allowed to let me up there, but he let me up on the roof, and he was holding me, making sure I wasn't going to fall anywhere. But yeah, I took the big wide-angle picture of, the 300,000 people on the Brighton beach. It was one of my best pictures I've ever taken, really. So
I was here at the ground 2 hours before the bomb went off. And then I went back home to bed and got woken up by the noise and came back again. Biggest story there's ever been. And the Argus sold 180,000 copies that day. And that's a record too.
I came today to witness the history of Brighton, really, which the Argus has probably captured better and for longer than anybody else. And it's a fantastic portrayal of the sort of political scene, the leisure scene, you know, just people, whether it's punks or politicians, that have graced the streets of Brighton for nearly 100 years. So it's a fantastic portrayal of the city.
It's amazing to put such a lovely amount of history together and to just take you back down memory lane all the time is absolutely wonderful, and to be preserved in this way is such a good thing, and it can only improve on all the things that we've seen so far. Very, very good, excellent exhibition.
Very exciting for us because we started advertising with the Argus back in 1972, and it was because of the Argus. And in those days we owned Sussex Stationers, which became British Bookshops.
Oh, I think it's a wonderful event. I think it means a huge amount to everybody in Brighton when you just see the numbers who've turned up and the interest that's shown. But it's got all of the history of Brighton. And then what you're also finding is that people are just looking back and recognising sports stars or pop stars, and it just takes them back. And I think, you know, everybody's reacted really well to it, but I can't believe the turnout already. It's fantastic.
It really is. I mean, it's an incredible event for us at the Argus, and of course, it just confirms our place right at the heart of Brighton, as we have been since 1880.